My name is Barbara van Koppen. I'm with the International Water Management Institute, based in the Southern Africa Regional Programs. And we have been working together with the domestic sector on a new approach to water services, which is multiple use water services. It starts with people's multiple water needs, especially in the rural areas, in peri-urban areas, where water is water. And where the distinction between this is water for irrigation or this is water for domestic uses, it doesn't make sense. Everybody knows that domestic systems are used for gardening, for livestock, for small-scale enterprise. It gives a lot of livelihoods, and everybody knows that irrigation systems are always used for multiple purposes, non-plant uses as well. And in a research sponsored by the Challenge Program on Water and Food, a number of organizations, including IRC in the Netherlands, IMI in several countries, and the International Development Enterprise, working in 8 countries with national partners there. In that research project, we found that multiple use water services are more cost effective because they anticipate on the multiple uses. So they bring more livelihoods, people's motivation to maintain the systems are higher as well. So for less money, we get more MDG per drop. This book is called Climbing the Water Ladder. One of the observations around really the world is that just thinking of 25 liter per person per day, 50, only thinking of domestic uses when we bring water near to the homesteads, that it isn't a reality. That whenever people have more water around the homestead, that they use it. So why stick to thinking that only water is only needed for drinking, but instead double or triple the quantities of water, so make people climb what we call the water ladder and give 50 to 100 liter per person per day from multiple sources, not only pipe systems, from multiple sources to bring many more livelihoods. At the community level, we also have been working on with the approach that you take the whole community, all users, including women and the poor, look at all the water needs for domestic, for cattle, for small-scale enterprise, for irrigation, and see where are the different water sources now, where do people need water, and really get an integrated approach to water services delivery. So RWRM is not a concept at the highest levels, but it is really something that can be operationalized very effectively at the community level, at the homestead level, at the household level, or in small-scale storage infrastructure, even in many irrigation fields, for example. There are also frogs that are raised or fish that is being cultivated, even on so-called agricultural fields. There is a multiple use of water. So by starting with people's already existing water uses, which are always for multiple purposes, and by designing in an integrated manner at the level of a community, we get a much more sustainable, much more livelihood enhancing form of water services.
Thank you.